Good afternoon, BHS. I'm Michaela Kiefer, and you're watching Cutlass TV News. Theater students attend the annual thespian convention in downtown KC. Here's a vlog by Connor Sizemore and Caitlin Morrison.
About a week ago, and kicking off the new year strong, the BHS Drama Club attended the 2023 Missouri State Thespian Conference.
Have a wonderful time at the Thespian Conference and have a wonderful 2023.
I remember my time in high school theater.
Welcome to the 2023 Missouri Thespian Conference. Peace.
Without further ado, here's live documentation of the events as they happened.
I'm super excited for a conference this year. We're going to be doing a lot of really interesting stuff, tech challenge and whatnot, acting with my friends, and then also learning from so many professionals.
Great job, Peyton.
Well, we just got to FestCon this morning, and it's been pretty eventful, as you can tell. We're in line for lunch, and it's kind of long. And I'm excited for improv later today. I think that's going to be really fun.
Flash on?
Okay. There we go.
You think it's good?
Yeah.
My thoughts, first Thespian Conference, tons of fun. We just got here, it's Thursday. So we got workshops coming up after this, and it's just gonna help us for the upcoming shows next year.
We've been doing a ton of cool stuff.
Yeah, go Missouri Conference!
Look at the beautiful city.
The workshops have been really fun. Lots of new things learned.
Not bad.
So improv just ended, and I think it went pretty well. Basically, what we do is we go in there, we don't know what the game is, and then they tell us it, and we have like maybe 8 to 10 seconds to talk to each other, and then we just perform our scene in front of a room of everyone, and later we'll find out how we did, and it's super fun and exciting.
How do you think it went?
Good!
How was improv?
It was good. It's my favorite event because there's no preparation part, and you make it or break it. Fake it till you make it.
I really have liked the improv workshops and yesterday's show, which is called Girls Like That. It was a really good show.
Hi. And I really liked the quality time I've gotten to spend with my improv team and competing with other teams.
Yeah, that too. I also like the improv.
This whole area is very neat. As you can see, why don't you pan this up really quick? Look at that. Very neat place. We're about to watch a show. We get to watch 3 total shows. We got 2 plays and 1 musical. Very excited. Definitely my favorite part of FestCon.
With Caitlin Morrison, I'm Connor Sizemore, and you're watching Cutlass TV News.
Here's a feature on winter sports top athletes by Maddie Ruffin and Andrea Gray.
Junior Shay Wright is new to BHS, but has already proven to be a leader on the girls' basketball team.
I lead my teammates by encouraging them and just communicating and just talking to them. I prepare for a game by just separating myself from everybody and listening to music and running the plays through my head.
Senior Gio Mack recently made his 1,000th point as a boys basketball player.
What I've done during practice and during off season is, just working on stuff that I do in games. Just trying to get a live action of what I'll see in games. So. Just kind of working on that outside of practice is probably my biggest factor, getting in the gym, getting shots up, so that I can just, play my best. How I prepare mentally is just, thinking about basketball and probably just, watching basketball, getting the feel. It's probably one of my pregame rituals, just watching it so I can get a lot of moves in my head and, how the flow of the game will be. And also probably just taking a nap and listening to some music. 1K.
Sophomore Louise Jewett works hard this season after placing at state.
Before a match, I prepare by, I listen to music and I kind of just sprint
up and down the hallways for a little bit to get my muscles moving, and then coach or have somebody massage my shoulders. You can't get better if you don't work. I mean, even when I'm tired at practice, I still work because you can't get better if you don't. And other people are getting better. So if you want to improve and show that you've improved and keep improving, you have to keep working or someone else is going to take your spot. You know? I would tell people that if you have like something you want to try, do it, because I mean, you're young, you can do it. Even if it's something that's out of reach, like, oh, I'm out of shape, but I want to do a sport. Go try it. You'll get in shape when you're doing the sport. Or, I don't know if I can do this. I have a class and I have a thing I'm going to pass. Well, if you study and you put your heart into it, I guess, you can do it. So, yeah.
With Andrea Gregg, I'm Maddie Ruffin with Cutlass TV News.
For this month's recipe, ProStart makes fillies. Here's a look at the recipe by Jeffrey Jones, Tyler Fulton, and Nick Pettit.
Good morning, Button High School. I'm Jeffrey Jones with Tyler Fulton, and we're going to be making your recipe of the month. The recipe this month is seared pork medallions with a pear and green peppercorn sauce, brown butter pumpkin spetzel, and shaved Brussels sprouts. So it's a great recipe. I highly recommend making it. So we're going to cover this down in four different parts. So for the pork tenderloins, you're going to need approximately 1 pound of pork tenderloin, 1/8 teaspoon of coriander ground, 1/8 teaspoon of cardamom ground, salt and pepper, that's going to be 2 tastes, 3/4 tablespoon of green peppercorns, this is for the sauce, 1.5 ounces of unsalted butter, 3/4 teaspoon of shallots, 1/4 teaspoon of dried thyme, 1 ounce of chicken stock, 4 ounces of heavy whipping cream, 2 ounces of apple juice, 1 1/4 pears, and 3/4 teaspoon of sugar. So the first step is you're going to cut all that silver skin off the pork medallions, cut them into little fillets, season them with salt and pepper, and put them into a screaming hot pan. Then you will sprinkle them on top of that coriander and cardamom ground mixture, right? Make sure to season them nicely, you have quite a bit of it. Then get yourself a nice little pot. You're gonna dice up a shallot, and you're gonna melt that butter down. And after you melt down the butter, you're going to throw all the shallots in, along with that whipping cream, the apple juice, and everything. Give it a good stir and let it reduce. Then you're gonna take the pear, cut it into 1/3 inch wedges, put it into a hot pan, sprinkle the sugar over the top, maybe even a little salt, and give it a nice little salted kick to it. You're gonna let those caramelize down, toss them around, make sure they're all coated all over it, hit that sugar. It's an amazing part, do not skip this. Once those pears are caramelized, we're gonna move on to this brown butter pumpkin spetzel. So for that, you're gonna need 1 1/8 cups of all-purpose flour, 1/2 teaspoon of kosher salt, 1/8 teaspoon of white pepper, a pinch of just ground nutmeg, 1 ounce of pumpkin puree, 1 large egg, 1/4 cup and 4 ounces of buttermilk, 3 tablespoons of unsalted butter, 1.5 cloves of garlic minced, 1.5 tablespoons of fresh parsley, finely chopped, black pepper to taste, 1/8 of a cup of grated Parmesan, and then water and salt as needed. You're gonna season it, 2 tastes of salt, and the water is there to, you know, in case you need help loosen that batter up. So the first thing is you're gonna combine all the dry ingredients into a bowl, whisk those together, add that pumpkin in, beat that in, then you're gonna add all the rest of your wet ingredients, the egg, the buttermilk, the water, and then you're just gonna whip it all together. You see, I only added part of the buttermilk here. That's just in case you need the extra 4 ounces. In this case, I did, so I used the rest of it. You're beating it all together. It's gonna look almost like a pancake batter. You see it pours out here, right into that little container. And then you're gonna take that container that you poured into, it's called a spetzel maker, by the way, slide it back and forth, just like this. Slide it back and forth like that, and it will create beautiful strands of this brown butter pumpkin spetzel. In this separate pan, you'll cook down some brown butter, put the parsley and the Parmesan in it, and then after that spetzel's done, as you can see, I'm putting it into, you see there, there's the brown butter with the garlic. The brown, you're melting down the butter, you're gonna add the garlic, some fresh parsley, give that a nice rough chop. You don't need very much of it, but it just adds this little green vibrancy to this. Then you're just gonna add that brown butter, the Parmesan, the parsley, toss it all together, and I promise you, it tastes absolutely phenomenal. The shaved Brussels sprouts with bacon and shallots. You're gonna need about 1/2 pound of Brussels sprouts, 2 slices of bacon, 1.5 garlic cloves, 1/8 cup of shallots, 1 tablespoon of lemon juice adds a nice deglaze in the pan, take all that bacon fond off the bottom, and then salt and pepper to taste. It's absolutely phenomenal. I would not skip this step at all. So take that bacon, you're gonna cut it into bite-sized pieces, throw it into a cold pan and let it come up. Then with the Brussels sprouts, you're gonna take the ends off of them, cut them into about 1/8 inch strips after you put them in half, saute those in that bacon fat, add the garlic, and you're just gonna move them around. Kind of let them cook, wilt down a little bit, and part four with the plating. So I like to put a bed of that Brussels sprouts. I think they taste amazing, add a nice acid. right in the center. Then you take that brown butter spetzel. You're going to set that on the bottom of where you want your pork medallions. Then on top of the pork medallions, add that amazing, wonderful green peppercorn sauce. And there you go. That is seared pork medallions with pear and green peppercorn sauce on brown butter pumpkin spetzel with shaved Brussels sprouts. I highly recommend making this recipe at home. And I'm Jeffrey Jones and Tyler Fulton, and you're watching Cutlass TV News.
Hi, my name is Ava Sullivan. I'm a junior, and I am your school board representative. Based on some of your questions regarding the HALO monitoring system, here are some answers from the board. The HALO will be installed in restrooms at Belton High School. They are projected to be installed by the end of March. The HALO detectors adapt to frequent and common sounds, and when it detects an abnormal sound, it will alert an administrator. The district's goal in this installation is to resolve common restroom issues by monitoring air quality, sound detection, aggression, and calls for help. If any student has any more questions, please email me or scan the QR code around the school to fill out the BSD Student School Board Google form. Thank you.
In your opinion, what is the greatest movie of all time?
Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade.
Next Friday. All Dogs Go to Heaven.
The original Major League.
I'm going to say The Departed.
Shawshank Redemption.
Lord of the Rings.
All About the Benjamins.
I'll be down to the White Chicks.
Thanks for watching. Tune in next week. And as always, Carpe Diem.